You'll see as I teach it, it'll be really broken down and we'll do it incrementally, and it'll really make sense because I'll have, between you and your partner, the more experienced person holding focus mitts, really that's the person that controls everything. If a focus mitt holder just held their focus mitts in and you guys were doing a particular drill and they only fed it to you once during whatever time limit that was, that's their prerogative because they control everything. Don't, as you're a focus mitt holder, get too wound up if somebody's got all this energy and you feel like you gotta hold this, and suddenly things start snowballing. But really, this is like the dictator. This is the person that's given me whatever my steady diet of you know, gestures is gonna be. So again, watch this whole end thing. Here we go. With that, and as I'm keep recording this, and maybe even kind of come to the board just so you can see this a little bit more, as we break this down, and this is just as just even for teachers, or if you're ever showing somebody, they often say like people learn in different categories, visually, I guess auditorily, kinesthetically. All that means is some people key in on things with how they see it, some people have to hear it. Some people have to actually feel it and do it. Nobody's all together in one of those boxes, but as you're showing somebody, at least when I try to teach, there's certain key elements that I throw in there. I write it out, people that are visual. Sometimes you see a whole map of it. Oh, they beat it, they hone in on that. Some people, just hearing that, sometimes I'll even make noises as I'm doing, like, ba ba ba, ba ba ba. Some people have to hear that rhythm, or just even like that sound of it happening. Other people, just even sometimes in sparring or focus mitt drills, if I see somebody doing a wrong combination, you know, I'll say, no, left, right, no, left, right, and they're hearing me, but it's not until I come over and I touch this hand and then I touch that hand and they're like, oh, lights are on, because I had to physically just kind of make this little alteration or suggestion. So here's how we do it. And just to even show in this drill, there's just three punches, as you saw. It's a cross, hook, cross. And then I'm doing something evasive. I'm bobbing down, okay? Cross, hook, cross, bob. Those three punches and that motion equal one combination. And doing that three times through equals one set. Now just to break it down with Brittany and me. She holds for that, and I go cross, hook, cross. One, two, three. That was one set. Within that one set, nothing happens that I have to worry about. It's only until the second set. One, two, three. Now I'm covering high. Then it goes third time through. I'm going body, fourth time through, body, body, and then fifth time through, they call it fading, right, fade back, and then I do a right cross. Now, when I get you guys up to partner, instead of, and this is how sometimes a drill like this, it can be like, okay, let's everybody do it right now, and then I kind of, you kind of have to go around and see who's never done it before, those that have done it plenty of times, monitoring them. But really, what we want to do, make sure that our person that is evading all this stuff, they just know the order. They just need to know the order. So here, first order, nothing happens. But what I want you to do with your partner, I'll get everybody up doing this, I just need to practice her feeding this so I can practice covering this spot. So give me one, there. Now give me body. Body, body, and then make me fade back, and then I can fire rock cross. This is how we started off incrementally. Once more, I go head, body, 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 then I fade back, and I right cross. All right, take your partners once I grab focus mitts.
going to put the fifth one in for him to fade. So yeah. If you've ever seen boxers just sort of warming up and they do like this, and they'll kind of like do this uppercut motion. And I mean, when they're sparring, they're not doing anything nearly like that. They're needing to do like a knockout shot, right? But why do you think they're kind of just doing this sort of small condensed motion? Maybe we all have our own answers to it. I don't have a set reason, but what I think is, you know, they're just trying to warm up the body and get nice fluid motion and get a lot of it going. So a lot of times when I work with focus mitts, I have people wanting to hit me in the temple or the head, and I want them kind of giving a nice reach. And also when I return fire, I want to deliver a nice reach. So oftentimes I'm twisting my body a whole lot. I'm really extending a whole lot. But within this drill, express purpose for this, I want you to get a lot of movement. I want this to be rapid fire, kind of how you saw me do it. So we're going to sort of dial it back a little bit. And when I have, oh, I'm sorry, yeah, can I grab Brittany to demo this?
Yes.
So, I'll just adjust her this way. As I described, most of the time, like, if we're moving around, maybe you're just focus mitt holding for me, and she gives me a shot out here, and I'm ducking under, or I'm having to cover, she's really reaching out far. But when we do this drill, and she's got both of them held up, I kind of talked to her about this earlier. I don't really want the side of this and really extend it out. I want to get in a little bit tighter, more like infighting. And I want to think about this last little, like, I don't know, like 10% of the focus mitt, or even like 20%, like kind of just coming up and hitting me in the temple, kind of going up a little bit higher for my head, which allows me to duck under and come back out the other side really quick. So here, as we go slow, just watching, and this is what the holder needs to do. One, two, three. I just need to duck down and just let that skim over me. One, two, three. And now you can see how I'm not like this. Otherwise, you know, yeah, it doesn't really have that fluid motion that we like, so, or with this drill. So, express purpose. Little. And when I talk about this bob, just like that footwork thing that we were doing earlier, and you're dropping down, just basically you duck. Later, those are more experienced. If you want to practice your weaving motion, that's great, but it's just kind of small, small and out the other end. All right, so go ahead and start working the cross-hook-cross-bob, cross-hook-cross-bob, just doing that. All right, just brief intermission. Is there anybody that wants to demo it out?
Oh, no.
Anyone, anyone? Okay, I'm gonna put another minute on the clock then. Nobody yet? Okay, go a minute more, just a minute more. All right, and time. Is there anybody that can demo it flawlessly? Anyone, anyone? Now just remember when I'm saying that high pressure word flawless, I'm not saying fast. You can go slow motion, as slow as you want to, but it just gotta be from start to finish, no hiccups. You can do it way slow. Okay, maybe the other side, but check it out. Let me at least demo this, or I'm gonna have Noel just record this. Oh, you don't have to demo it. Just recording, like, I used to hear sometimes someone I heard an instructor describe once, slow can be fast. And I was like, well, how do you come to that? Slow equals fast, what? And like, and all you had to do is throw in this word in the middle is this. Slow is smooth. Anybody can be hysterically fast and sloppy as hell. And it can still be, I can have power too. But slow is very smooth, smooth, smooth. And smooth, as you dial it up on the volume, control that dial, smooth can become fast. So just really how you get from this to this is that smoothness. And again, it's just like how when I talk about a boxer doing this, that's a very smooth motion. Same for this. That's very smooth, and again, it's just as we incrementally learned this,
it was like that idea, you're all capable of getting on and doing a bench press, and we could load up plenty of plates, and everybody could burn themselves out on a couple, right? But things can break down, sometimes doing it that way. It makes more sense to put, okay, let's try a few plates, small, do a few. More, load up more, okay, a few more. So what the, it's just progression. So learning should be the same main mind frame. You're progressively learning it, because if we just did it all at once and I say, okay, have at it, the mistakes that you start to make at the start can stick with you. So it's better just kind of do it really, like I said, incrementally, very smooth. Thank you. All right, let's see it. Nice, very good, very good. Cool. Good job, nice. All right, here we go. Yep. Remember guys, watch this, because you're...
One. Two. Close enough. It's all good.
All right.
It's fine. It's good.
All right.